This would soon benefit one band in particular. Dead or Alive had struggled in 84. Late in that year, they got new producers and a new lease of life. But their first single, Together, proved a challenge.
It was the most frustrating record in the history of Stock Aitken Waterman. It would go up one week, go back the week after. They would go up and it would go down.
After the whole of the rest of that year, it still hadn't really cracked the top 40.
So Pete Waterman took it under his personal belt to make sure that it was a hit.
CBS said they wanted another mix. Now, I have to tell you, at this point, we'd done about five mixes. We're running out of ideas. And the BBC had a sound effects department, and you could buy these sound effects records and covered everything. Every sound you could imagine was on these BBC archive sounds, you know, doors, you know, bridges, bombs, police sirens, everything. So I'm looking down this and I noticed there was, on one of the sounds, was two dogs having intercourse. Now, why anybody would want the sound of two dogs having intercourse baffled me. We got carried away with it and we put it on the record. So it went out just about the week before Christmas. So when we came back, first week in January, every club was playing this TDF mix. I mean, it was like the depot was full of orders. TDF, was not tour de force. It actually stood for two dogs.
Through January 85, the TDF mix edged the song up the charts. And as fate would have it, in the last week of January, Top of the Pops introduced their new slot, featuring bands just breaking into the top 40.
And suddenly, 14 weeks in, it was number 40, and they decided to give us a break on Top of the Pops as a sort of new entry.
This song has taken 2.5 months to make the chart. From Liverpool, it's Pete Burns and Dead or Alive. You Spin Me Round Like a Record.
So when Michael Hurl called you and said, you know, we're going to put this record on as a breaker, we knew at that point that was the break we needed. No matter how many mixes we'd done, the fact that Top of the Pops was going to show the video, we knew it was all over. Because we knew that once people saw Pete with his eye patch, with all the flags, we would be in the top 20 the next week. We knew. And that's the power that Top of the Pops had.
We've got a new number one for you on this week's Top of the Pops, another live Top of the Pops, of course. Dead or Alive, another Merseyside fan.
You want that moment where your dad goes, well, I've seen it all now, don't you? You know, oh, well, that's ridiculous. I'm sure there were houses throughout the UK going, what's that?
The dog howls on Dead or Alive's infamous TDF mix were programmed with a keyboard sampler.
Hey!
This new tech was much loved by